All these are the all these are the questions of metaphysical poetry, multiple choice questions, so objective type questions, okay, important for the exams. The very first is to be learnt, who was the leader of the metaphysical poets? Okay, this kind of question can be asked, that who was the father or who has been regarded as the father of the metaphysical poet or the leader of the metaphysical poetry. So, who was the leader? It was John Donne. John Donne was the leader of the metaphysical poets. Okay, most important question. Which poets believed in analysis of emotion? It was metaphysical, that is, which poets, okay? These were metaphysical poets. All the metaphysical poets, they believed in the analysis of emotion. Whose poetry is harsh and rugged? Of course, the poetry of John Donne. John Donne's poetry is harsh and rugged, okay? Because John Donne's poetry is very difficult to understand. We can say that the poems of metaphysical poetry were, metaphysical poets were very obscure. Then next one is the term metaphysical. The term metaphysical is made up of two words, meta and physical. Okay, this word metaphysical, it consists of two words, meta and physical. So what does it mean? Meta means beyond and physical means nature, right? Meta means beyond and physical, that is nature. The prominent figure of metaphysical movement is, again the same question, it was John Donne. The prominent figure or the father of metaphysical poetry. Now, in the next question, you can be asked all the important features or characteristics of metaphysical poetry in this way. The salient features of metaphysical poetry are peculiar blend of passion. Okay, there is a mixture of passion and thought, expression of deep thoughts and philosophical conception of the universe. Then next one is there appeared a race of writers that may be called metaphysical poets, and it was the beginning of 17th century, means it was the 17th century when there appeared a race of metaphysical poets. Ninth one is the metaphysical poets were the men of learning. The metaphysical poets, they themselves regarded or they preferred to be called themselves as they were the men of learning, and it was said by Dr. Johnson that they were the men of learning, and they also expressed this in their poetry. Then the next important question is 10th one, who said, okay, most important, who said John Donne affects the metaphysics? It was John Dryden. John Dryden said Donne affects the metaphysics, and for the first time, when Donne he was composing the metaphysical poems, he was not aware even of this word. It was for the first time, it was John Dryden who for the first time said that John Donne affects the metaphysics. Okay, so this question is very important. What type of style have the metaphysical poets used? What type of style? It was unconventional style, okay? It was unconventional style that was used by the metaphysical poets. With what is a metaphysical poem overloaded? Metaphysical poem, there is a wit, image, conceit, but there is a lot conceit. Metaphysical poem is always overloaded or full of conceits, right? Then the next one is 16th one again, because metaphysical poetry, okay, metaphysical poetry or metaphysical poem was overloaded with conceit. So we can say that the major characteristic of metaphysical poetry is conceit, okay? So conceit is the major characteristic of metaphysical poetry. Then 17th one is John Donne compares a man and the beloved who stay at where? To a pair of compasses, that is travels and home. John Donne compares a man and the beloved who stay at travel and home, and they were husband and wife. That was John Donne and his wife. 18th one is the nest of singing birds was transformed into a grove of nice speculations. It is said about metaphysical era or metaphysical period that the nest of singing birds was transformed into a grove of nice speculation. Okay, nice speculation, that is thought, because they were men of learning. Then the next one is 21st. Historically, the age of metaphysical poets is known as Caroline Age. Okay, historically, this age, metaphysical period or metaphysical age, this is also known as the Caroline Age. Who said the proper study of mankind is man? It is said by Alexander Pope. Alexander Pope, who belonged to the 18th century. Who is the father of modern English prose? John Dryden. John Dryden is the father of modern English prose. That is, now in the above question you were asked that who affects the metaphysics. Okay, who said that John Donne affects the metaphysics? So in this way you can be asked the same question that you can be given fill in the blanks and then affects the metaphysics. So truly it was John Donne who affects the metaphysics. Then the next one is 26, then 27. Andrew Marvel. Andrew Marvel wrote the poems which include To His Coy Mistress and The Definition of Love. Okay, Andrew Marvel, the name of Andrew Marvel's poem was the very first, To His Coy Mistress. Okay, very famous poem of Marvel, and the second one, The Definition of Love. Richard Crashaw, he was also a metaphysical poet. Andrew Marvel was also a metaphysical poet, and the literary work of Richard Crashaw was Delights of the Muses, Steps of the Temple. Okay, both were the literary composition of Richard Crashaw. Who didn't have the respect for the parliament? It was Charles I. Charles I didn't have any kind of respect for the parliament. Then the next one is 39th. The metaphysical poetry is called as the poetry of wit. Okay, as I have told you that the main characteristic of metaphysical poetry were three: conceit, wit, and image. So the metaphysical poetry is also called as the poetry of wit. Then the next one is 46th. The peculiar quality of metaphysical poetry are they always perceive similarity between dissimilar. Okay, that is conceit. It was very important that the metaphysical poets, they always perceived similarity between dissimilar, and they use figure of speech excessively. Okay, in their poetry we find a lot of figure of speech. The similes and metaphors are far-fetched and are often taken from unfamiliar sources. Okay, they used a lot of figure of speech, especially simile and metaphor, and they were taken from unfamiliar sources. Means the readers, they were very surprised when they found such kinds of or those kinds of comparison. 48th one is George Herbert is known as a religious poet. Okay, George Herbert, he is known as a religious poet, and he was also a metaphysical poet. So George Herbert was both a metaphysical poet and a religious poet. Nothing can be more fine, manly, and unaffected. It is said by George Herbert. Okay, by George Herbert, nothing can be more fine, manly, and unaffected. Then 51 is who gave the name metaphysical poets. Who gave the name metaphysical poets? It was Dr. Samuel Johnson. Dr. Samuel Johnson. The peculiar blend of passion and thought is the greatest achievement of metaphysical poets. Who said? It was Grierson. Grierson said that the peculiar blend of, there was a mixture of both emotion and thought, passion and thought, and that had always been the greatest achievement of metaphysical poetry. 53 is the metaphysical poets expressed deep thoughts, okay, deep thoughts in which language? In simple language. The metaphysical poets expressed deep thoughts in simple language. Then the 54 is, what is conceit? What is conceit? Conceit is a deep, fantastic idea. It is a comparison. It is an image or comparison emphasizing similarity. Then next one is, Donne is famous in the history of literature. Why? Why is John Donne famous in the history of literature? Because he is the founder of metaphysical school. He came to rescue the Elizabethan poetry from its mellowed music, that is melodious music, and conventional diction of the Elizabethan era. It was John Donne, he came to rescue the Elizabethan poetry from its melodious music and conventional diction of the Elizabethan era. Then the next important question, 63. For how many years did the Civil War of England, for how many years did the Civil War of England continue? For 6 years, the Civil War of England continued. The supporters of the People's Party were known as Roundheads, okay? Who were called Roundheads? The supporters of the People's Party. In 1649, okay, this is very important, in 1649, the Civil War ended, and the King Charles I, who didn't give any kind of respect to Parliament, he was also defeated and executed in 1649. Then the 66 one is the book Advancement of Learning. It was written by Francis Bacon. Next one is, they influenced the poetry of 20th century. They were, or who influenced the poetry of 20th century? Okay, these were metaphysical poets who highly influenced the poetry of 20th century. Then the 75th one is, the metaphysical style was established by John Donne in 17th century. Okay, in the early 17th century, the metaphysical style was established by John Donne. In recent times, English and American critics have devoted much attention to the work of metaphysical school. Metaphysical school. English and American critics, they paid their much attention to their work. Now, the last one is, the metaphysical literature has been blamed for what? The metaphysical literature has been blamed for obscurity because of a lot of excessiveness of figure of speech, because of their difficult or obscure language and style. So the metaphysical literature has also been blamed for obscurity. So all these were important questions of related to metaphysical poetry.